Let's look at the solution to our DRAM access scheduling quiz. So we have 32 arrays, each is 16 megabits and takes a 12-bit row address and a 12-bit column address. 12 bits is 3 hex digits. So the row address will be the upper 3 hex digits and the column address will be the lower hex digits. Each of these corresponds to a 32-bit memory location. So what happens is each of these arrays sees the same address, but it provides a different bit for that address. So each address will have the same sequence of row and column addresses, it's just that they will implement different bits of that address. So what we have here is the first one, of course, needs to be a page open. So we have 10 nanoseconds to open this first page. We will then read in 2 nanoseconds. Then we will close the page in another 5 nanoseconds because the next one is on a different page. The row address is different. So we spend 17 nanoseconds here. We will spend another 17 here. We will then spend another 17 here because it's again a different row. 17 here, and here, and here, and here. Overall, we have 7 accesses, each to a different page. So each of them requires 17 nanoseconds for a total of 119 nanoseconds. Now let's try to reorganize these. What we want to do when we reorganize these is once we open a page, access everything on that page before we move on, which means we will open this row and then we will access everything in that row, which means this and this too. Now what happens is we spend 10 nanoseconds opening that row, 3 times 2 nanoseconds reading these 3 things, and then we need to close the row in another 5 nanoseconds. Then what happens is we open the next row and we read everything from that row, which includes this too. So we end up opening one row, reading 2 things from it, and then closing it. And now we spend 17 nanoseconds for each one of these. In total, we spent 74 nanoseconds doing these accesses. So as you can see, when caches have a number of pending misses and we need to send these misses to memory, it pays to rearrange the order of the addresses we are accessing to benefit from the organization of the DRAM.